I feel like I was ultimately changed for the better by my time in prison.
It was an overnight stay.
You become a different person in the joint, but the important thing is to just remember who you really are.
It was jail. There's a difference. You were never charged with anything.
I don't think I could have made it without the memory of my girlfriend to keep me strong.
Well, you didn't call the memory of your girlfriend at 4 o'clock in the morning to pick you up.
Wow, that is such an amazing story. You've been through so much.
I don't think I could have done what you did.
I think you'd be surprised at what you're capable of, girl, too.
That's sweet of you to say.
Seriously?
Your girlfriend is so lucky.
Well, unfortunately, Susan and I have parted ways.
Oh. Why?
She just couldn't handle the strain I was putting her through. I don't hold any resentment against her, though. When I expelled drugs from my life, I abandoned all hate and resentment with it. Our lives are just lines on the tapestry of life, intersecting and bouncing off of each other for as long or as short as they are meant to be. No more and no less. Our time together will always be special to me, but I'm afraid it just wasn't meant to last long.
Wow. Here's your coffee and your bran muffin.
Thank you, Anne.
No problem, Eli.
Thank you, Anne.
No problem, Tyler.
I wonder what Anne looks like naked. You know, I bet she's got the body of a goddess and the stamina of a synchronized swimmer. Yeah. I must find out.
What?
You know, I see her all the time. She gives me coffee. It makes sense. We're basically dating.
I don't think you know what dating is.
That settles. Anne is the girl for me.
Fine. Seduce Anne. Go for it.
Hi. Did I ever tell you I once snorted a line of baby powder when I was 14 and had an allergic reaction?
What the hell is she laughing at already?
Oh my god, that's so funny! You're so amazing for pulling yourself out of such a dark place!
I'm glad you think that. You know, I like to pull myself out of your dark place, if you know what I'm saying.
We're going to a party with her tonight.
Really? Wait, what'd you say to her?
Actually, I talked about you.
No, seriously.
Usual stuff I talk about. Drugs, prison, rehab.
Just don't do anything to piss her off.
What are you talking about?
We have a tendency to be less than sensitive, regarding girls' feelings, you know, with matters such as, you know, relationships, returning phone calls, keeping promises, remembering names.
Hey, that is not true.
Hey, Tyler.
Hey, girl seven.
Just don't make it impossible for us to go to the coffee shop anymore.
I promise I will not screw up with Anne. So I'm on this box, and this dog's just barking and barking at me. It's gotta be like a pit bull or a Dalmatian, something weird. And there's this moment, right? And we look each other in the eyes.
Yeah.
And it felt like our spirits became one. Like I was one with the dog was one with me.
Right.
I swear to God, this shit was real.
Okay.
And I look it in the eye, and in my mind, and I'm just like, dog, stop. You know? And I swear to God, as soon as I said that, dog backs off, lays down on the ground. So I get off the box.
Right.
And I put my hand on his head, and I just say, good boy.
No.
Yeah. So great, man. And I swear to God,
You seem unimpressed.
Huh?
With that guy's story.
Oh no, he's a friend of mine. I was actually there for that story. It's mostly true. He's just embellishing it a little to get attention.
Well, everybody does that a little.
Trust me, Tyler's an expert at it. He can play up any terrible situation to get attention from girls.
Well, he doesn't have my attention.
I'm Eli.
Melody.
Nice to meet you.
Hey.
Hey, how are you?
I'm good.
Yeah?
So what'd you think of the story?
It's a really good story.
Yeah?
I kind of like it about the dog. I really like dogs. Yeah.
You like dogs?
Yeah.
What kind of dog you got?
I got a little chihuahua at home.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Am I going to be able to see this chihuahua sometime? Or?
I don't know. What are you doing later?
I don't know. You know, I got a friend over there, but you know, he looks a little busy, so...
Yeah, I mean, you can ditch him. Hang out with me.
Yeah, show me your chihuahua. Yeah, I'd like to.
Seriously, at 3 a.m.?
Yeah.
And you actually drove out there?
Yep.
That's a 5-hour drive! You're clearly a much better friend than I am. I probably would have gone back to sleep.
I'm sure you're a great friend.
Sorry. Oh, sorry, I have to take this. It's my boyfriend. Hello? Hi, baby. Oh, I'm just talking with a friend. Yeah.
Thanks for coming by.
Thanks for having us. It was a lot of fun.
Sure. Bye.
Bye. Cough. Oh, for the love of God. I can see you're internally committed to Anne.
Hey, well, to be fair, her name was also Anne. Or Cassie, or something like that. Listen, that's not the point. Look, what the hell's your problem?
I just spent the past 3 hours having one of the best conversations of my life with an extremely attractive girl.
That sounds like a good thing to me.
An extremely attractive girl with a boyfriend.
I'm sorry, and not to sound insensitive or anything, but what the hell does that have anything to do with me? Wait. Wait. I'm not the chick's boyfriend, am I? Because I was getting really good at the whole breaking up thing. What was it? Was her name Veronica? Short, lazy eye? Because I swear to God, the whole prosthetic arm thing?
No! Hell no! That's not what I mean at all! I'm just getting sick of you telling your stupid stories and getting every single girl you meet to like you. And meanwhile, I seem like one of those boring people in existence.
I mean, you do eat Bran Muffins.
What's wrong with Bran Muffins?
Oh, come on, they are clearly the most unexciting of all breakfast pastries. What's your problem, you know? You've always been kind of boring. It's kind of your thing.
What is that supposed to mean?
I don't know, it's just that I'm the interesting one with the cool past, and you're the... Bran muffin-eating best friend who is reliable, you know? Like Han and Chewie.
You're not interesting. You just make it seem like you're some super enlightened person for all the stupid shit you've done in your life. When in reality, you're just an insensitive, selfish asshole with no regard for anyone else but himself.
It's kind of harsh.
No. This is a little harsh.
What? All right, what are you doing? Come on. Haha, very funny. Come on. Hey, what do you do? All right. You made your point. I see it. You're going off. That's great. Now, could you let me in the car? Let's talk. Come on, bud. What are you doing? Eli, what are you... All right. You're pulling away. You're flicking me off. That's great. Come on. Now, come on back. We could have ran over my foot just then. All right, you're at the stoplight. You're going to turn around. You're going to come... Don't take that... Wait, he's taking the... Well, fine. Just drive off then, all right. I'm just gonna go make out with girl 9 and get a ride from her. And by get a ride from her, I don't mean just in her car, if you know what I mean. And by in her car, I don't just mean in her motor van. Ah, he's gone.
coffee and a Bran Muffin. Wait, chocolate chip. No. Blueberry. Low-fat blueberry.
I haven't seen you in a while. Where's Tyler?
Oh, to be honest, we kind of got into a fight.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that. Do you want to talk?
No, it's okay. You're working.
It's okay, I could use a break. So, what happened?
It's nothing, really. I'm just getting sick of Tyler always lying to impress people. All the while, I seem like his boring sidekick, for being honest.
Oh, come on, he's not that bad. I mean, he makes his stories a bit more interesting, but everybody does to some extent.
Not to the extent of Tyler.
Oh, really? Melody seemed to think you were the world's greatest friend. Something about Tyler calling you at 3 a.m. to come and pick him up, and you were nice enough to drive 5 hours to get him.
She mentioned that to you?
Yep. But in reality, he was able to get a ride from a stranger about half the way back. Somehow that got left out of the story.
That's not the same thing at all. Oh my god, I do the same thing as him!
In a way, yeah, you do.
Oh my god, I'm a horrible human being.
No! You're a good friend for coming out at all at 3 a.m. And you're a human being for trying to make it sound cooler than it really was.
Thanks, Anne.
No problem, Eli.
No, seriously, you're a good friend.
Thank you. You know, Tyler's a pretty good friend, too, for trying to hook us up.
When did he do that?
You didn't know?
Hey, Anne, laugh like I just said something funny.
The hell is she laughing at already?
What was that about?
Look, Eli is lame. He likes you and would like to ask you out on a date.
Really?
Yes, but he won't for some overly thought out or contrived reason. So, I thought I'd hook you guys up with an equally contrived plan.
Why is he talking to himself like that?
Oh my god, that's so funny! You're so amazing for pulling yourself out of such a dark place!
He likes to do that when he thinks nobody's watching.
How adorably peculiar.
Oh my god, he did that?
Yes, he did.
Wow, I kind of feel like a jackass right now.
That's probably an appropriate feeling.
I'm sorry, I have to go.
I understand.
Hey, this may seem like a stupid question, and you could tell me if it's too forward or whatever, and I totally understand if you didn't want to, but you maybe want to go on a date this one?
Pick me up from my place at 7. Oh, and by the way, I love Bran Muffins.
We talk.
I got nothing to say to you.
I brought you a soda.
Come in.
Oh, hey, Earl 9.
Dude. Her name's Julie.
Maybe we should go outside to talk. Look, I just wanted to apologize about last night.
Okay, I forgive you.
No, let me finish. Wait, you're not mad?
No.
Then why did you say, I don't think we have anything to talk about?
I was waiting for you to offer up the soda.
But I left the party because I was jealous that you were more interesting than me.
Yeah, and that really turned out badly for me in the long run.
So you're not mad?
Look, I've done a lot worse in my life. Hell, I've done a lot worse to you. In my life. When we were 14, I sold your video camera to a pawn shop for what turned out to be a bag of baby powder.
You stole my video camera?
You didn't already know about that?
No!
Well, let's not linger in the past. Look, the point is, you have forgiven me on dozens of occasions when I've done bad to you, and you've always been there to help me out, so I will always forgive you when you freak out about not eating exciting enough food.
Thanks, man.
Yeah, no problem. Come here, man.
Hey, Just out of curiosity, why'd you make me think you were trying to seduce Anne?
I wanted you to stand up for yourself and finally admit that you like her.
Really?
No, I was just fucking with you. But when we tell the story, could you make it out like I was a bit nicer?
Sure thing, buddy.
So when are you coming back in?
That's what she said.
You should go.
Oh, just hold on a second. This is going to be some precious bro-bonding time.
We're waiting, Tyler.
Precious bro-bonding time up. See you later, Eli.